Walker just spotted a giant python over here.
But these little kids are just absolutely adorable.
Oh. We're gonna put him down and, oh, okay, I got him. I got the big snake. Look at this, guys. I saw a tick on it. Didn't you see a tick, Walker?
Yeah, it's right here.
I'm gonna start with this big one right here. We're gonna go in 3, 2, 1. Oh, look at that big tick right there. And on camera, I'm just gonna squeeze it.
What is up, everyone, and welcome back to the channel. I hope all of you guys are having just an absolutely amazing Monday. Now for today's video, we are actually going to be hopping in reverse to yesterday. Yesterday we were at my buddy's farm feeding his lizards, and we were walking on his farm, and right over in the bamboo there was about a 12-foot python in the bushes down in Homestead, Florida. Now obviously you know me very well, and of course we caught the python, but the python was actually loaded with ticks. We pulled probably, well, I'm not gonna reveal how many ticks we pulled off. You are gonna have to watch the video to find out, but the python was absolutely loaded with ginormous ticks that we pulled off. So if you guys wanna see that, stick around for later on in the video. But before we hop into today's video, I wanna show all of you guys some baby kittens that my sister rescued. Unfortunately, the mother was actually killed by a car, but we rescued her babies, and I'm gonna show you them now.
We're entering my sister's room in 3, 2, 1. Oh my gosh, there they are. The little tiny kittens are right over here. Oh, there's another one right here. Oh, there's actually two right here. Well, we'll start with these two little guys right here. So we rescued a total of 4 kittens. We have 2 gorgeous black ones that are spotted, and then we have 2 gorgeous orange ones with the most amazing eyes. I mean, you can see this guy's little blue eyes are just absolutely incredible. And then we have this little guy right here who has blue eyes as well, but he's more of a black and spotted cat. Oh, look at you, little guy. You're so cute. Go right now, stop what you're doing, and go comment down below which one is your favorite. Do you like the orange one better, and do you like the black one better? I want to know, so go in the comments and let me know. These guys are just absolutely adorable, but unfortunately, their mother was killed by a car. My sister got a phone call, so we did rescue these little guys. Hi, little boy. Hello, how are you doing? And one of the crazy things is, and I believe it's this one right here, I believe it's this one, was actually born with no tail. I have never seen that before in a cat. You can see right there where the tail would be, there is just no tail at all. So we have a tailless cat right here. So go right now and stop what you're doing and go comment down below a name for the tailless cat. What should we name the tailless cat? I wanna know. Go comment down below. These guys are just absolutely adorable. Can you guys come out? Oh my goodness, I love your little face. These little kittens are just so, so cute.
We're actually going to be adopting these kittens out. We had a family come by yesterday. They looked at 2 of them and they decided they were going to adopt an orange and a black one. But we're pretty sure we have homes for one other one too. But these little kids are just absolutely adorable. Oh, you wanna play with me? Look at them, they're playing with each other. Look at these siblings just having an absolute blast playing with each other. Can I play with you guys? Can I play? Boop, 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 boop,
boop. These 4 kittens are just absolutely adorable. I mean, just watching them play, I could probably sit here for hours and do it. These 3 siblings right here are just wrestling around, and this little guy right here is my favorite. I'm a little bit partial to him. I love his look. He's got black, and then he's got orange. His face is white. These little kittens are so cute. Oh, you're licking your paws? Those are some yummy paws, huh? Those are some good tasting paws. Hi guys. But it's just awesome just how tiny these little kittens are. Can I see you please? These little kittens just fit so perfectly in my hand.
Sir, are you looking for a place to poop? I think this one's looking for a place to poop or pee. It's in the little litter box that we have here. Hi. I guess I'll leave you to your business. And now that all of you were able to see these absolutely adorable kittens, we are going to hop right into today's video.
Guys, I just got the camera out of the car. We're here at the farm taking care of the lizards, and Walker just spotted a giant python over here. Walk, you have it? Oh my god. Guys, take a look. This is live action right here. We just got a big, about 11-foot python, bro. Bro, you want me to take over?
Yeah, come grab.
Okay, I'll come. Guys, this is like a wild Burmese python here sitting in the bushes.
Oh, it's gonna strike.
It's gonna come. It's gonna go at him. Walk. Here. Take the camera. Oh my gosh, bro. Oh my gosh. Okay,
all right,
come on.
Just grab him, Jacob.
This snake is just absolutely mad right now. Right now he's just trying to get away. Let me put my shoe back on.
Yeah, too.
This is like the perfect opportunity to grab the snake. Oh my gosh, bro, this is a big one. Guys, we're gonna get the shoe off. All right, we're gonna put him down. And, oh, okay, I got him. I got the big snake. Look at this, guys. We got a giant, about 11-foot Burmese python that we just caught out. Wild here. at our farm while we're taking care of our lizards. This snake right here could have literally got into the lizard cages. I'm here barefoot walking around, and this is just living on an 11-acre farm. This giant python is about 11 feet and it's hot, but now that we've caught it, this snake is kind of calmed down. Let me get off my shoulders because it's starting to constrict around my neck. Look at this snake. This snake is just absolutely gorgeous. Come take a look at its head right here. I want to show you his teeth. This python's teeth could hurt you pretty badly. I just want to open its mouth up so you can see those serrated teeth that go all the way backwards. Now, if you guys have been watching my channel for a while, you will know that we find a lot of pythons here in South Florida. This snake is an invasive species from Southeast Asia, and they can get up to 18 feet long. And this one is the nicest one that I've caught in a while. I mean, look at it. She is just so thick and so big. But I thought I saw a tick on it. Didn't you see a tick, Walker?
Yeah, it's right here.
Where?
Right over here.
This python here is just absolutely loaded with ticks. I mean, right here, there's three ticks right there. There's actually one right here by his eye. I don't know if you could see it. It's a small little tick. Walker, you have alcohol in your car, right?
Yeah, I do.
Okay. We're going to go to the car right now. We're going to take the snake with us, and we're going to get alcohol. Be back with all of you guys in a second. We're back from the truck, and we have our alcohol to remove these ticks. The reason why we're using alcohol is we don't want ticks to spread on the farm and actually spread to the iguana, so we're actually going to be putting them in alcohol, which is going to kill them. Unfortunately, since this python is an invasive species, they're eating our native wildlife, we are going to have to humanely euthanize it, but we do want to remove the ticks so none of them fall off into the grass during the process in which we skin him. We're just going to pour some of the alcohol right in here for these ticks, and we're going to start with these big ticks. I think that they were right over, where are they? They're right here. We're going to start with this big one right here. We're going to go in 3, 2, 1. Oh, look at that big tick right there. And on camera, I'm just going to squeeze it. Guys, take a look at that. That right there is black sludge that just came out of the tick. That right there is the python's blood. These ticks can get extremely large just sitting here sucking the python's blood. So we're just going to put the tick inside of the alcohol right there. That's the first tick that's gone. We have a couple more. Let me try to find them again. All right, we got another one right here. We're just going to pull that one off. We're not going to pop this one. We're just going to place that one inside of the alcohol. I mean, right now it's springtime in South Florida and the ticks are out and they're just everywhere. This snake is starting to get active again, wanting to move around. But you can see just how big they are, but just how tiny they are. That little gray spot right there is a tiny little baby tick right there. Just a micro tick that we're pulling off of this python. We're just going to fling that little guy right inside of the dish. We got to try to find some more ticks. I mean, Walker, do you think this snake could be like, grab it right now, full of eggs? I mean, she's really thick. What do you think, bro?
I don't know, man.
She doesn't really feel like it. Take a look at this. This is just one absolutely massive tick on this python. This one really isn't full of blood. It's kind of just flat like it just got on there. We're just gonna pull it out. And you always wanna pull the ticks out and make sure that you get their heads. A lot of times their heads will get stuck, and when they get stuck in there, they'll actually regrow. So this one actually doesn't even look like it's alive, but we're gonna put it in the alcohol anyways. So we've gotten most of the ticks off of this snake. We just got this last one right here, a tiny little baby tick, and you can see it's just kind of crawling on me. These ticks can be on the snakes, they can be on us humans, dogs, cats, pretty much anything that has blood, these ticks are gonna wanna suck on. We're just gonna put this little guy in the alcohol. And Walker, I think we're done here. I think we got all the ticks. What do you think, man?
I think so too, bro.
I think so too. And that, my friends, is going to end today's episode. I hope all of you guys did enjoy watching it. I had no idea that coming to find iguanas would lead to catching just an absolutely massive python. If you guys enjoyed today's video, please go give it a thumbs up and comment down below what you thought of this crazy video. And if you guys are not subscribed already and you enjoy the content, well, guess what, guys? It is the first link down below. Go subscribe.